Anker SOLIX is one of our favorite brands when it comes to quality and innovation in power stations. But they're not the first company you think of when you think about integrated home backup or saving money on your electric bill. With their all-new Power Saver kit, they might have just released a solution to help them compete in the space. But what we wanted to know was, is this thing any good, or is it just another product that another company's launching in an effort to take a jab at making a little bit of extra money? So welcome back to the lab, where our opinions cannot be bought. We recently released a video on Anker's brand new F3000 power station. It performed really well. We were really big fans of it here at the lab. We would recommend that to you guys. But on its own, it's not really designed to be used for whole home backup. And personally, we wouldn't really use that unit for peak shaving, or any power station really, for that matter. In an effort to make the F3000 a little more versatile, Anker has released this bi-directional inlet box, as well as a smart home meter, and they've kind of packaged it up together and called it the Power Saver Kit. It's basically a box with a 20 amp breaker that you can wire directly into your fuse panel in your home. It kind of replaces the need for a transfer switch. You just plug the unit directly into this. This plugs directly into your panel, and you can backfeed power into your panel to power a circuit in your house. It's cheap, doesn't really require professional installation, and it's marketed as being able to save you ton of money. This is basically Anker taking the F3800 and their home power panel and trying to make it a little bit more accessible. It's kind of the first jab we've seen at using a power station to shave some money off your electric bill. As always, we have links in the description down below, as well as any coupon codes that we can get out of Anker to help save you guys some money. If you're interested in these products, we also have a link to our quiz. It'll help you guys pick a power station if you don't know exactly what you need. And if you haven't already and you enjoy watching our content, please make sure you guys hit the subscribe button. It helps keep the lights on here, keep Tiny Baby fed. Anyways, before we share with you guys our experience with the Power Saver kit, we're gonna hit you with a super quick teardown in case you're not already familiar with all these components. The kit consists of two components that must be used together. First, you have your bi-directional inlet box. This is the part that you actually tie into your grid. You plug this portion in right here at the bottom. It goes into your inlet box. And then the cable on the other end plugs directly into your F3000. So this is actually one piece. And the other part is the smart meter. This is a little Wi-Fi antenna so you can connect to it. It monitors the flow of power into your home's panel using current meter clamps. They're super easy to install. They just clamp over a wire coming off of the breaker that you're using in your panel. Nothing tricky about setting those guys up. You basically treat this right here as a plug and you wire it directly out of the top of this unit and allow it to supply power through a breaker there. And then once you have your F3000 plugged into the other end of this guy, you can use the power from your grid to charge the F3000 during the night. And then during the day on peak hours, you can use the F3000 to shave some of that cost off your bill, or you can charge the F3000 with solar panels and skip paying for electricity altogether. You could generate your own power with solar and then feed it into your house to help shave even more money off your electric bill. Anker also advertises this kit with the F3000 and some expansion batteries, so you can build this beyond just the capacity of one unit, which is cool because you could charge up more than just the F3000's rated battery capacity, and you can offset as much as you want based on how many batteries you have. In simple terms, mount this on the wall, plug your F3000 into it. Power goes from the F3000 into your panel. Power comes from your panel, goes through this into your F3000, bi-directional, and then...
No! No, and then!
Use your Anker app, connect to this guy, it monitors your power, you're good to go. It looks complicated, but it's very simple. If you guys are looking for a full install breakdown, Anker already has an entire video explaining that on their channel. And right now, at the time of filming, this bi-directional inlet box with the smart meter, no F3000, just this kit, is $448. I believe if you buy this with the F3000 at the same time in the bundle on their website, it's only actually $200, but we're about to get into if that's even worth doing in the first place. The first thing that we really like about this setup is that the system allows you to use solar as well. It's not just a bi-directional box where you could take power from the grid and put it in the F3000 or the other way around. You can actually generate your own power with solar panels and then feed it into your grid, which helps you offset additional costs. So you're not really peak shaving, you're actually just saving money in general, which is a really cool feature. Unfortunately, if you buy the big foldable 400 watt Anker solar panels, they are priced as if they're Ferraris. So I would recommend you get your panels somewhere else, but still a really cool feature. The second thing that we really like is the installation is very easy. As long as you're comfortable with very simple wiring, installing this is really a no-brainer. If you were comfortable enough with wiring an outlet in your home, you can wire this thing. It's really no different. The monitoring app portion of this is actually really cool too, because it allows you to track the consumption in your entire house, not just what you have going on with your F3000. So that's like a really cool perk to the app. And this setup is that you can actually monitor your whole home's power consumption, keep an eye on everything, which we personally found pretty cool. The app also has some pretty cool storm features. It allows you to control the reserve in the unit in case of an emergency. So say you never want to deplete it past 50%, you can actually have it function as if 50 is zero. And it also has storm forecasting on the app, so it'll pay attention to weather patterns, and if it sees a storm coming, it can actually force charge the power station no matter what you were trying to do with it at that time. It'll force it to take a charge, make sure it's completely full before that storm gets to you, which is a really cool feature in case you're at work or you didn't know the storm was coming. The storm tracking feature on a lot of other apps is kind of gimmicky, but this is actually a really cool, useful, real life thing that you could use. Basically, if you already had an F3000, this is a really cool addition that can help you save a little bit of money with it instead of just dragging it around for camping or wheeling it into the kitchen in an emergency situation. This is a really cool extra feature. It also works nice if you're trying to pair it with something like a window air conditioner. You can pair it directly to that air conditioner and kind of have them be a buddy system so that you're just offsetting that air conditioner with your F3000 instead of a traditional system where you would power the whole panel. You could pretty much just set it to one device and try to save your money just on that one appliance. When it comes to things that we don't like about this though, the first one is that they kind of advertise it as if you could replace an outlet in your home with this box, but it needs communication cables run. So not only would you have to assume the outlet is already on 20 amps, and you have to assume that it has the appropriate 12 gauge wire, you would have to somehow run a communication cable through your existing walls to get to your panel. It's not really practical. I think the only real life place that you would mount this is like we did, which is kind of just below or beside your existing panel. So that's kind of a buzzkill. They position it as like a whole home backup solution. They say you could power a sub panel or even your whole home, but the reality is with a 20 amp circuit and 12 gauge wire, even if you had two of these and you were running 240 volts, you're only backing up a few critical loads. You're not going to be able to power your whole home, especially if they're bigger appliances. You're really only going to be powering a couple things.
We just don't want people to be confused.
No, it's just a little misleading when you look at how it's labeled and then when you actually go to use it. It's also slightly annoying that this only works with the F3000. It doesn't work with the F3800. So if you guys already had some Anker products and you were in their ecosystem, you can't just use this. You have to buy the F3000. This is limiting and we don't love that.
It's kind of like iPhones. I just learned the other day that you can plug an iPhone into another iPhone and charge it.
We call that docking. All of this considered, the big question here, is it worth it? Yes, but mostly no, and let me explain why. Anker says that the ideal package is one F3000, one expansion battery, and 1200 watts worth of solar panels with this power saver kit. Right now, on Anker's website, it costs $5,298 for this exact package. Mostly, this is because the panels are way too expensive. So $2,900 without the solar panels is what you're looking at for just the F3000 expansion battery plus this kit. But assuming you get it with those panels, the math that we did includes them because that's how you offset the most off your electricity bill. Here's what's going on. Assuming you get 5 good sun hours at peak sun, which is actually a lot if you live somewhere more north, you're gonna generate about 6 kilowatts of power per day from your solar panels. At an average of 25 cents per kilowatt hour, which is the number that Anker says is like the average cost, you would save roughly $1.50 per day by dispersing that power you generated with your panels back into your home. This will potentially save you about $500 per year. To get that though, you have to have everything hooked up permanently all the time with perfect sun every day, and you're never using the F3000 for anything else. Like you're never taking it camping, you're never doing anything with it. It's always plugged in right where it sits, doing its exact same job, basically treating it like a traditional solar kit. So not accounting for inflation, which is crazy these days, it'll take over 10 years to pay back your original investment of about $5,300.
Plus now you've got $3 million worth of shitty Anker panels that are blowing away in your backyard.
Yeah, that too. And all this for a solution that can only service a maximum of 20 amps. Where it could make sense to us is if you were trying to offset a specific appliance. So say that you got a window air conditioner for your bedroom and you wanted to offset that with this unit, then yes, you're just trying to power that air conditioner only with the F3000. That can make a little more sense, but if you're trying to just launch this into your whole home and try to start saving some money with it, it just doesn't add up. It can make more sense if you got off-brand solar panels or if you already had the gear and then you just wanted to buy this additionally to tie it into your home. The bottom line is, this is just inconvenient. What we would do is if you're actually just trying to save some money on your electric bill, you could take that $5,000, and you could go to Signature Solar's website and you could get an EG4 6000 XP, which is double the size inverter and it does 240 volts. You could pair that with an indoor wall mount battery, which is 14.3 kilowatt hours of storage, which is just over double the F3000 plus an expansion battery. That system will last you 3 times longer in the event of a power outage. You could expand it way bigger than you could expand the F3000. And sure, that doesn't include the price of panels, but you can get the Sirius 415 watt panels are like $187 per panel. It doesn't take very much money if you're getting a hard panel and doing like a traditional route to really start getting a decent sized solar array for pretty cheap. Even without panels though, that kit is big enough that you could just do the peak shaving portion of this and not generate any power, and you'll still offset the cost faster than you would offset this. So at the end of the day, we appreciate Anker's innovation. They're trying to do something that hasn't really been done before, and there is potential in what they're doing. They haven't really nailed it yet, and it's not really something that, in our opinion, we can recommend to you guys. But we like to see the direction they're going, and we hope that more people keep trying to take a stab at this. But let us know what you guys think. That's all we got for you guys in today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you are subscribed if you're not already, and check the description for coupons and our Power Station quiz. Otherwise, we will catch you next time. Thank you so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.